Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss precautions and side effects of quetiapine. Quetiapine is one of the antipsychotic which is given in the form of ester quetiapine fumarate. This drug is available as a tablet and it is an atypical antipsychotic. Being an antipsychotic, this drug can reduce the psychotic disorders. Quetiapine can reduce the positive symptoms of schizophrenia, such as hallucinations, where the patient can feel either auditory or visual hallucinations. Even there is no sound or light is existing, still the people can think there is a sound or light existing in the surroundings. So quetiapine can reduce these hallucinations, delusions, wrong perceptions, which are classified as positive symptoms of psychosis. Similarly, this drug can also reduce the social withdrawal, which is classified as a negative symptom of schizophrenia. So quetiapine can reduce both positive as well as negative symptoms of schizophrenia. Apart from these clinical indications, in few of the patients we can observe the mood swings from depression to the mania or mania to the depression. Such type of bipolar mania disorders are again controlled by quetiapine. So it can be used both in the psychosis as well as in the treatment of bipolar mania. And being an atypical antipsychotic, this drug produces theoretically less extrapyramidal side effects. But still we have to consider few of the precautions with use of quetiapine. So today in this video, we are going to see what are the important precautions and side effects of quetiapine fumarate. First of all, let us start with the precautions. The first precaution is the metabolic changes. Use of quetiapine can produce few of the metabolic changes in the patients. It can increase the glucose levels. So with increased serum glucose levels, the patient may have altered FBS values, the fasting blood sugar values. So this is more important in the patients with type 2 diabetes mellitus, where they are already having elevated levels of glucose. In such patients, quetiapine should be carefully used as this drug further increases the glucose levels. So caution should be taken when quetiapine is indicated in the diabetic people. Similarly, this drug can also increase the LDL cholesterol, triglycerides, even total cholesterol, which increase the risk of atherosclerosis and other cardiovascular disorders. Therefore, again, in those patients with already elevated cholesterol levels, this quetiapine should be carefully used. With elevated levels of both glucose and lipids, quetiapine can also increase the weight. So weight gain is another important precaution that should be considered with quetiapine on long-term use. Around 7% increase in the weight gain can be observed with use of quetiapine. But all these effects can be controlled within the limits with proper use of quetiapine. Therefore, on long-term use, the serum glucose levels, serum cholesterol levels, and the body weight of the patient should be thoroughly monitored. Second one is the orthostatic hypotension. Quetiapine acts by multiple mechanisms and one of its effects is on the blood vessels. These blood vessels are equipped with alpha-1 adrenergic receptors. These alpha-1 receptors mainly produce vasoconstriction, but quetiapine can block these alpha-1 receptors, thereby it can inhibit the vasoconstriction. When this vasoconstriction is not observed, it results in vasodilatation. This vasodilatory response of quetiapine can produce orthostatic hypotension. This is the fall in the blood pressure with change in the posture. That's why it's also called as postural hypotension. Because of orthostatic or postural hypotension, quetiapine can produce few of the symptoms such as dizziness and lightheadedness in the patients, which is troublesome in the elder people. Since this drug produces vasodilatation, it reduces the blood pressure, which may stimulate reflex mechanisms. Because of reflex action, quetiapine can increase the heart rate, resulting in tachycardia. Within first few days of the treatment with quetiapine, the patient can observe some syncope, falling sensation because of orthostatic hypotension. Third one is the neuroleptic malignant syndrome. This is commonly observed with many of the antipsychotics. So quetiapine can also produce neuroleptic malignant syndrome, resulting in few of the symptoms such as excessive body temperature, hyperthermia, muscle rigidity and muscle spasm, increased heart rate resulting in tachycardia, unexpected confusion. All these symptoms can be observed with quetiapine and it indicates the development of neuroleptic malignant syndrome. So any sudden increase in the body temperature along with muscle spasm should be thoroughly monitored as it may indicate neuroleptic malignant syndrome that is commonly observed with many of the antipsychotics. Even this is a rare condition not observed in all the patients, but definitely it is a serious condition where it increases the body temperature excessively. So care should be taken to check the development of neuroleptic malignant syndrome. Fourth one is the cerebrovascular effects. Since quetiapine acts on the CNS, it can also increase the risk of stroke in the patients. The risk of stroke is more pronounced in those patients with any pre-existing risk factors such as CNS tumors, head injury, a recent stroke. In such patients, quetiapine can further increase the risk of stroke. Therefore, in such group of people, this drug should be avoided. Even this drug should be carefully given in the elders, where quetiapine can produce some cognitive impairment, which is more troublesome in the elder people. Fifth one is the tardive dyskinesia. This is one of the extrapyramidal side effects that can be observed with quetiapine. Even this drug produces somewhat less extrapyramidal side effects compared with typical antipsychotics. But still, this drug can produce few of the extrapyramidal side effects such as tardive dyskinesia. With use of quetiapine for long term, this drug can produce slowly developing irreversible muscle spasms. So these effects are observed after at least 4 months of treatment with quetiapine. That's why tardive dyskinesia is a slowly developing extrapyramidal side effect. In this condition, we can observe some involuntary movements, jerky movements, and muscle spasms, which are irreversible in nature. So once they are developed, they cannot be restored easily. So after a few months of the treatment, if any irreversible muscle spasms are observed in the patients, then this drug should be stopped in order to avoid further development of tardive dyskinesia. Sixth one is a dysphagia. Quetiapine can produce some difficulty in swallowing because this drug can reduce the motility of esophagus. Because of reduced esophageal motility, the patient may feel some difficulty in swallowing, which may increase the food in the aspiration. So quetiapine should be carefully given to the patients with aspiration pneumonia. Seventh one is elevated prolactin levels. Dopamine is one of the important neurotransmitters which can control the prolactin levels. But many of the antipsychotics can reduce the dopamine levels. Thereby, they can raise the prolactin levels. So quetiapine is an antipsychotic which can block the D2 receptors. Thereby, it can reduce the dopamine action. When the dopamine action is going to be reduced, the inhibitory effect on prolactin is removed, resulting in the excessive elevation of prolactin leading to hyperprolactinemia. This hyperprolactinemia may result in breast tenderness, breast enlargement, milk secretion, nipple discharge. All these effects can be observed within the men because of elevated prolactin levels. Eighth one is agranulocytosis. Quetiapine can produce one of the condition agranulocytosis, just like the clozapine and the antipsychotic. So with use of quetiapine, we can observe few of the symptoms such as development of fever, sore throat, decrease in the blood counts leading to leukopenia, aplastic anemia, neutropenia. All these effects can be observed with quetiapine because of agranulocytosis. When this agranulocytosis is going to be developed, it can increase the risk of infections in the patients. So care should be taken to check WBC count and absolute neutrophil count with long-term use of quetiapine. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. The important side effects mainly include somnolence, the sleepiness in the patients, dizziness, and drowsiness. It can also produce some abdominal pain, constipation. Pharyngitis is another important side effect because of reduced esophageal motility. And it can also produce some fatigue, weakness, and lack of energy. Other side effects mainly include the weight gain, which is commonly observed with use of quetiapine. Similarly, this drug can produce some dry mouth and increase the heart rate, resulting in tachycardia. All these side effects are commonly observed with quetiapine. So these are the various precautions and side effects of quetiapine fumarate, which is an atypical antipsychotic. One of the important precautions of this drug is the metabolic changes, where this drug can increase the glucose levels and cholesterol levels within the body, and it can also produce weight gain in most of the patients. Orthostatic hypotension is another important precaution, where it can increase the dizziness and drowsiness in the patients. Neuroleptic malignant syndrome may be observed rarely in the patients, which may develop excessive body temperature along with muscle spasms. This drug on long-term use can produce tardive dyskinesia, irreversible muscle spasms, and even it can increase the prolactin levels, resulting in breast tenderness and breast enlargement within the men. Dysphagia is another important precaution that should be considered with this drug. Again, this drug can produce agranulocytosis, resulting in the increased risk of infections with decreased WBC count. So these are the various precautions and side effects of quetiapine fumarate. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.